surprise.
Beautiful.
Sleepy. Go see mommy.
She's trying. Neither one of them did. Aww. Please rise. We have known and believed that the love that God has for us, God is love, and those who remain in love remain in God, and God remains in them. I invite you all to be seated and welcome you to this service. Dylan and Grace, these people have gathered here in this place today to celebrate your love for each other. You have found one another and took the time to grow in understanding and love together. Now you stand here and seek the blessing of God with the support of your friends and family in this public act of commitment. The service does not have magical properties, nor do the words that I say or the words that you say. It will not mysteriously make you, your relationship, something that does not already exist. Instead, it gives you the opportunity to draw a line to cross together, entering a new covenant and declaring from this day on, we go forward together, sharing all we can, supporting each other in difficulty, and loving each other in all times and in all ways. Friends and family gathered, you also crossed this line with Grace and Dylan, vowing your support and love for them. This covenant joins two families, creating a new community of love and friendship. We take this time to surround them with affection and prayer, celebrating their love for each other and giving thanks for God's beautifully reflected in them.
Be thy name.
This is off script, but holy moly. Thank you for blessing us with your gifts. Oh my gosh. Let us pray. Eternal love, you gave us this day, a day of expectation and of joy, of earnestness and of happiness, of certainty and of joy. Today you give us new beginnings. We ask you, hear our prayers, our thoughts, and enable Grace and Dylan to grow in grace and love all the days of their lives. Amen.
The reading is from Ecclesiastes 4, 9 through 12. Two are better than one, because they have a good return for their hard work. If either should fall, one can pick the other up. But how miserable are those who fall and don't have a companion to pick them up? Also, if two lie down together, they can stay warm. How can anyone stay warm alone? Also, one can be overpowered, but two together can put up resistance. A three-ply cord doesn't easily snap. The second reading is from Colossians chapter 3, verses 12 through 17. Therefore, as God's choice, holy and loved, put on compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Be tolerant of one another. And if someone has a complaint against anyone, forgive each other as the Lord forgave you. So also forgive each other. And over all these things, put on love, which is the perfect bond of unity.
Dylan and Grace, please join your hands as you make your vows together. Dylan, repeat after me. Grace, my beloved.
Grace, my beloved.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
I give you all I have.
I give you all I have.
And all I am.
And all I am.
And take you as my wife.
And take you as my wife.
I love you.
I love you.
And as far as it is in my power.
And as far as is my power.
I will always love you.
I will always love you.
When times are difficult.
When times are difficult.
I will stay beside you.
I will stay beside you.
I trust you.
I trust you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
Today, I give you my life to keep.
Today, I give you my life to keep.
And Grace, I hope we were paying attention because we're doing the same thing. Grace, repeat after me. Dylan, my beloved.
Dylan, my beloved.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
I give you all I have.
I give you all I have.
And all I am.
And all I am.
And take you as my husband.
And take you as my husband.
I love you.
I love you.
And as far as it is in my power.
And as far as it is in my power.
I will always love you.
I will always love you.
When times are difficult.
When times are difficult.
I will stay beside you.
I will stay beside you.
I trust you.
I trust you.
And honor you.
And honor you.
Today I give you my life to keep.
Today I give you my life to keep.
Grace and Dylan, what symbols of love do you bring to remind you of the promises you make to each other that brings you here today? Let us pray. I'm assuming there's something about missing the rings that I missed. I ask. Let us pray. Loving God, make these endless circles of precious metal symbols for the unending love and faithfulness these two have for each other, and reminders of the covenant they enter today. We pray this through Jesus Christ, the perfection of your love. Amen. Grace, put this ring on Dylan's finger and repeat after me. Dylan.
Dylan.
As God gives us the sign.
As God gives us the sign.
Of never-ending love in Jesus.
Of never-ending love in Jesus.
I grace you with this ring.
I grace you with this ring.
As a sign and seal.
As a sign and seal.
Of my life with you.
Of my life with you.
On our journey.
On our journey.
Which is just beginning.
Which is just beginning.
Each day I will walk.
Each day I will walk.
Hand in hand with you.
Hand in hand with you.
Give me the second to. And that's why we say stop. Dylan, put this ring on Grace's finger and repeat after me. Grace.
Grace.
As God gives us the sign.
As God gives us the sign.
Of never-ending love in Jesus.
Of never-ending love in Jesus.
I grace you with this ring.
I grace you with this ring.
As a sign and seal.
As a sign and seal.
Of my life with you.
Of my life with you.
On our journey.
On our journey.
Which is just beginning.
Which is just beginning.
Each day I will walk.
Each day I will walk.
Hand in hand with you.
Hand in hand with you.
Let us pray. God of love, bless Dylan and Grace in their continued travels on the journey of life together. May their love for each other be renewed from day to day, and may their capacity to care be refreshed from day to day. May they always turn to each other for support and love, and may they remain confident in meeting each other's needs. May they be friends and may they be lovers. May they know care and may they know comfort. May they grow stronger together day by day, and may they always know fulfillment in each other's company. Loving God, may your ever-dependable love surround Grace and Dylan, and indeed surround us all. May your amazing, irresistible grace enable them to continue keeping the promises they made to each other today. May you fill them with your joy and guide them in your way this day and always. And may you continue to bless their home and family life. May you help us all to be faithful to the light and values which we seek to walk. Through Jesus Christ and in the presence of the Holy Spirit we pray. Amen. Before the love of God and in the presence of family, friends, and the body of Christ gathered here, Dylan and Grace made vows to enter the covenant of love and life together. I now declare them married. May all who God joins never separate. And I will do this because you don't care about me anymore. I present to you for the first time ever, Grace and Dylan Holstetler. You may now celebrate your love with a kiss. Hold up. Just a second. Calm down. I know you're super excited, but I still have like 2 more minutes. What you do in word and deed, do everything in the name of our loving Savior, Jesus Christ, giving thanks to God through him. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you and lift up countenance upon you and give you peace. Alleluia. Amen.
Thank you. thank all of you for being here and sharing this special day with Grace and Dylan and all the Hostetlers in Garvin's. Most of you know they met at Northwood University and actually they just happened to be sitting right next to each other for the freshman at their freshman orientation. So that's how it all got started. 5 years later, they got engaged in the Northwood gym where they both played, right at half court. And here we are today with Mr. and Mrs. Hostetler. Now, Dylan is an accomplished fisherman. He's good. And he and Dalton have provided fresh fish for us. Which we really appreciate. And Grace is quite a baker. In fact, she made the cake and all the cupcakes that you'll have later. We tried to tell her that was quite a project to take on just a few days before your wedding, but she wanted to do it, she had a plan, and she got it done. But I do have to warn you two that if you ever have anybody here to dinner, there are high expectations for the meal and the main course and the dessert. Thanks again for being here. I hope everybody has fun tonight. I'm going to do the same toast that I've done 3 times. And also my brother did it for Kathy and me 35 years ago. So it seems to be working. If you'll raise your glasses. To love and laughter and happily ever after. To Grace and Dylan. All right, well, I do want to recognize a few people who helped out. Tom Monier did the sound back at the church. Our pianist, Sue Krieger. Our soloist, Lorelei McDermott. Who else? Who also sang at Kathy and my wedding. And also Pastor Robert Brown, who gave us that wonderful ceremony and who will now say grace. Let's give a big round of applause to all 4 of those, if you would, please.
So clearly you all listened to me for 35 minutes, so you want me to spend another 35 minutes, right? I do appreciate that it was my congregants who were loudest about that. All right, let us pray. Loving God, we thank you for this opportunity to celebrate with this beautiful couple, to give thanks for their love, and to just enjoy our time together. Please be with the conversations around these tables, that we may all grow in love and fellowship from one another, and that we may strengthen our bonds of this new family, of this new unit, and this new marriage. In Jesus' loving and gracious name we pray. Amen.
Time to kick off our speeches. I'm going to go ahead and pass the mic up to Katie and Rachel. They're going to kick off our speeches.
All right. I'm a teacher, so I know how to get a room quiet. All right. Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for being here today to celebrate Grace and Dylan. I'm Katie, Grace's older sister. And I'm Rachel, Grace's oldest sister. We are so excited for the Hostetlers, and we wanted to celebrate with a little trip down memory lane. Because Grace is 5 years younger than me and 7 years younger than Rachel, we have some fond memories of her growing up. Poor Grace. As the baby of the family, we sometimes gave her a hard time. One of my most specific memories of this was when she was 4 or 5 and had lost a board game with the family. Grace doesn't like to lose. And she didn't then either. You see, Grace had a little quirk of talking to herself in the third person. We would often hear her in the mornings in the bathroom, talking to herself in the mirror, practicing conversations and just babbling away. She was also known to narrate her life and feelings. On this particular day, when she was 4 or 5 and had lost the board game, she became upset. Again, Grace doesn't like to lose. So, when Katie and I rolled our eyes at her for being angry, she got up, stormed up the stairs, and we heard her under her breath saying, "Gracie is so angry at Rachel and Katie. They are so mean to her." Needless to say, it was hard to keep from laughing. Fast forward, and Grace had no trouble keeping up with Katie or me anymore. She excelled in pretty much every aspect of her life. To give a shortened version, Grace was an all-state basketball player, still holds the all-time leading rebounding record for our high school, graduated top in her class, got a full ride to play basketball at Northwood, graduated with her undergraduate degree and MBA in 4 years, found a job with a not-for-profit where she helps homeless women and children find stability, and got married to the one and only Dylan Hostetler. And how perfect is Dylan for Grace? Like Grace, Dylan is active and loves goofing around. He's quietly competitive and already incredibly successful in his job. Dylan has a kind heart and always asks about us and what is going on in our lives, which we are sure he learned from his own thoughtful and caring family. Plus, we have learned more about fishing from Dylan than maybe we will ever need to know. And he turned Grace into a cat person. They are also such a great aunt and uncle to our kids, the three who actually made it down the aisle today. We are so excited for Dylan and Grace and their new adventures in Michigan. In fact, we are pretty sure that if someone finds herself in the bathroom at the same time as Grace today and listens carefully, she just might hear Grace talking to herself in the mirror saying, "Gracie is so happy. She found the man of her dreams." So raise a glass to Mr. and Mrs. Hostetler. Cheers.
A round of applause for them. That was a good speech. So first, I'd like to thank everyone for coming. I know everybody's been thanked a bunch of times already, but this means a lot to all of us, and we're very happy to have everybody here. So what a great day to celebrate the joining of two amazing families. For those that don't know me, my name is Dalton. I'm Dylan's brother. There are probably so many things that I can mention about Dylan. I could spend all day up here, but I'll do my best to keep this short and sweet. Obviously, we've known each other since we was kids. That's a joke for Dad. As most brothers do, Dylan and I didn't always get along. We had our fair share of fights and arguments, as most brothers do. We started to figure out, though, as we got older, that even though we didn't always see things eye to eye, we were pretty close on most things. And I'm happy to say that this part in our relationship and this part of our lives, he is my best man. He is the best person that I can rely on and think of to this day. Some of our best times were spent, you know, just the two of us in the middle of nowhere, stuck in a trout stream, and even though he's catching the big one, picking my pocket, I'm like, how the hell did he do that? I just casted there, and then he'd cast there and catch the big one. He did it more than once, too. I still love him. One thing I wanted to be sure to mention today was how proud I am of him. I'm not sure that I was always the best brother to express that growing up, but I hope he knows that everything that he has done to this point in his life has made me just amazingly proud. Dylan has been through his fair share of rough patches in life, as we all have, and I can honestly say that no one that I have seen has taken it in stride as he has. The dude's got big shoulders, and I'm not saying that just physically, but mentally. Dylan has a knack for taking things on and not sweating the small stuff, as Grandpa would say. And I think that was a good lesson that, you know, we both learned, and he learned a little better than I did because I hang on to stuff a little too long. But he is always moving forward and up, not letting little things get to him. And I think the phrase, never let him see his sweat, fits him pretty well. Grace, I cannot say enough about you and how happy we are to have you in the family. When Dylan and you had been dating for just a while in college, I remember asking him at one point, "So you really like this girl, huh?" And Dylan responded in typical Dylan fashion, "Yeah." And that was about it. But, you know, poked and prodded a little bit more for some more information. And I said, you know, why? And he responded something to the fashion of, "She's fun to be with. It's easy to be close friends with her without trying to force things. She's just different." And that may not be the exact quote, but that's what was portrayed to me. And I think that fits pretty well. He's a man of few words, Grace, so you're going to have to do most of the talking. And I'm happy that you are able to put up with his constant picking and prodding and pranking, because you're taking a lot of heat off the rest of us. Overall, I can't think of any better match for each of you. Your goals, your attitudes, your lives all complement each other very well. And I'm happy to finally meet a family who is, I think, just as competitive as we are. With that being said, I hope you both will be patient and always support each other. I've heard Dylan get a lot of advice these last few days. And, you know, come to mind four few phrases come to mind. Those are, "I love you," which should be said often and with commitment. "Yes, dear," which I think was a lesson that Grandpa always tried to teach us when he was possibly frustrated or maybe didn't want to do something that he kind of had to do, but the support and happiness of your spouse is more important than your uncomfortable feelings, I think. So maybe missed that one, but I think that we're getting it now. The other one is, "I'm sorry." Gotta be able to say it. Gotta be able to admit when you're wrong, which I don't think is hard for either of them at this point. I think they're pretty good about that. And the last one, Grandma's favorite, "You were right." Dylan and Grace, you may have a few things that, you know, you disagree on in life, but I hope that you communicate with each other and work through things. And Dylan, you may have to try, you know, one of those four and kind of see which one works best. And then I hope that you continue to grow together as a family, knowing that no matter the struggles that you may encounter along the way, you will not be alone. To close, I'd like to wish you both the best and a life full of happiness. Love you both.
You say it's the key. goes by the front door. Don't forget the keys in the morning. The child's expression always stays on the church, cause your mama says there's a good only chance that you can. Won't be wasted time. Always stay home in time.
Thank you. Yeah.
Well, it is now. Yeah. But not then.
Please exit the next floor.
years, and you're married 47 years or less. Three. One, two, three.